Hello friends, welcome to Parthams. Today we are going to see the very good feature and the filtering or you know highlighting option in Excel that changes color with the value of the cell. So for your information and reference, I have created this table for the inflation rate that has been happening from January to March. Or you can say the reference that has been taken from the month, that is December 19, January 20, then February and March. So what we are going to do here, if inflation value is more than 7, then that should be red in color. If inflation value is more than 6, so I'm just giving the reference values here. You can give the top as well for the reference, mid or high, that you can do. But for reference purpose, I'm just choosing some values for the mediator or for the reference. So if the value above that in a cell or the whole sheet, the whole workbook, that will be highlighted in the certain or the specific color. So let's choose the range first, okay? And how to give the color for that specific cell with the cell value, and it depends on the cell value. So for that you have to select the cell range only like this, then you have to choose home and conditional formatting. So what it does, it highlights the the cell with the reference or the color or schemes you are doing or the using in your day-to-day work. So on the conditional formatting, I'll choose a new rule, and in new rule there is second option called as format only cells that contains value. So here you can see the cell value and multiple options. You can choose a specific text if it is contains specific text or not containing, and then the dates occurring, if it is occurring on yesterday or next week or last month, that also you can choose. There are certain filter values that you can choose over here, but for now we are just comparing it with the cell value as of now. So it's showing as bring this in the back side so we can choose it correctly. So format cells with cell value, it should fall between. So first condition I'm going to give it as, if it is falling between that specific range or the less than or the greater than options I can choose. There are multiple options you have, that will highlight here. So first we'll choose less than. If inflation rate is less than 6 for now, let's say it's a cell value. After selecting this, I will select 6. If the cell value is less than 6, you have to choose format. The format is most important over here, like which color you have to specify for that. So as this value is green zone, so I'll choose green as a color, or whichever green you want to choose, or you can select it from the fill effect, and you can choose pattern style also if you wish, or the style for this. Okay, I'll choose the green color because it's less than value. Okay, if value is less than 6, so it will highlight it in green. So that means for that period, or the values, you can say the inflation rate is quite good, okay for the specific country that has been calculated or analyzed. So first condition formatting I'm providing here, so it will highlight me the values which is actually less than 6, which is quite under control for the inflation rate. So and the the previous values I can compare it. Then the next is, if I want to change the color, just don't observe on a values why it is showing. We are just observing the sales values and the condition formatting in between. So these are all fake values or dummy values, you can say. I'll again make it similar way, like if values between the cell value as, I'll choose now between, so it's a mid-range. This cell and the second highest upper point, that is 7, if the value is falling between these two, okay, So it should go in amber color or orange color. So it should highlight as a warning that it is going to be high in some ranges. So once you see the values between, that is the reason you can see the 6 and 7 is automatically calculated. What we did earlier is less than 6, that is the reason it did not equal to 6, but we are now going for value in between, so it will calculate 6 as well with Excel. And similar way for the higher values, we'll add one more rule for this. And let's say the first value is, I'll say greater than now, and there is one more option for the previous. If you can say greater than or equal to for a 6, if you want to 6 also included in green zone, that also you can do. But for now I'll just choose a greater than, and the cell value is a 7. Yeah, and format I want to show it as a red, so it's in danger. So once I click, so for now I have not choose the range. If you can see the changes here, you have to select the range and apply the conditional formatting. And you can choose this worksheet from the drop down on the top here. Ideally it should show, but if it doesn't, you can delete that rule again and create it. So let me delete this rule. Okay, and I'll choose the sheet, create new rule, select the cell is greater than again, and values 7. In format I should give it as a red color field. Let's say apply. Oh, it went for current selection again. Let's do it that way. Create new rule. I'll just remove this rule earlier. Okay, new rule. And if you can see, the selection is already made. And then go for select and greater than. Choose this cell value. Once I select this, and I can apply and say okay, you can see the values greater than 7 are highlighted in red. Alright, so once I go for okay, now how to manage this rule? If I want to change the color, my manager has to change this color to red from, you know, or change this amber color to yellow. What I need to do, I have to go for condition formatting again and go for manage rules. And here you can select the values. You can just simply edit tool after selecting this, and here you can change the format and choose as a yellow color. Once I select, click on OK, and again once again OK, and final OK. So if you can see, the color has been changed. So this is how we can, you know, change the color of the cell as per the value you have selected or provided with the condition. So I hope you like this video and you utilize this facility or the functionality in various analysis where you have to highlight the, you know, numbers or the digits or the analyze data in many reports. I hope you like this video, and give likes and please do subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video.